we will focus on the complex tissues. As we know that simple are divided into three, parent, colon and the sclerenchyma. Now complex tissues are a group of different types of cells performing same function. Okay, so they are made up of different type of cells. As the simple tissues are made up of single type of cells, but the complex are made up of different type of cells. And they are divided into two, xylem and the phloem. Xylem contains xylem tracheids, vessels, fibers and parenchyma. Phloem contains sieve elements, companion cells, phloem fibers and the phloem parenchyma. Okay, now we will move on to the xylem. So on the basis of the growth, xylem can be classified into primary xylem and the secondary xylem. So the primary is present in the primary growth, they come earlier in the plant, and later on secondary xylem is formed in the plant body. So now see the diagram. Here you will see that they are the remains of the primary xylem, which is the pith region, and this one is the secondary xylem, which accumulate later in the life of the plant. It is also known as the wood, and outer protective layer is known as the periderm. Okay, now secondary xylem is present in secondary plant body, and it is made up with the following four components. They are tracheid, vessels, fiber and parenchyma. Among these four, only the xylem parenchyma is living. Just remember it, okay? Only the xylem parenchyma is living, and the rest of the components are the dead. Means xylem tracheid, vessels and fiber, they are the dead elements. Only the parenchyma is the living one. Now let's learn about the components of the xylem. First is the xylem tracheid. So if you see the structure of the tracheid, they are elongated. Narrow lumen. Lumen is very narrow inside these cells, and they are tapering ends. Okay, if you see their structure, they have the tapering ends. Cell wall is made up of lignin. Okay, you will see the lignin thickening around it, and the thickening can be scleriform, annular, reticulate or pitted. I'll show you the diagram how it looks. If the thickening are in the form of annular, you will see they look like a ring. Okay, here you will see the ring like a structure. So they are the thickening of the lignin in the form of rings, and known as the annular thickening. Then these are the spiral thickening in the form of ribbon. Okay, they are the spiral thickening. Then reticulate. In the reticulate you will see they are network like. Okay, in this you will see a network is there. Then in the pitted case you will see in somewhere the thickening is not there. So it will form a pit over there. So these are the thickenings, and they are known as the annular, reticulate, pitted or scleriform. The scleriform is not there in the diagram. Scleriform, you see them, they will seems to be look like a ladder. Okay, you have seen ladder already. So they look like ladder. So it develops soft wood, also known as non-porous wood. So see the diagram of the soft wood. So this is the soft wood, also called non-porous wood. So this is made by the tracheids, right? And it helps in the conduction of water, give mechanical support, and helps in the formation of wood. So main function is to conduct the water. Tracheids and vessels, xylem tracheids and xylem vessels, their main function is to conduct water only. Just remember this, right? Now next are your xylem vessels. They are elongated, broad-ended. Tracheids are tapering-ended. They are broad-ended, cylindrical elements with wider lumen. Tracheids have narrow lumen, but vessels have the wider lumen. Walls of the vessels are lignified. Tracheids walls are also lignified. Here, xylem vessels are also lignified. Thickenings may be annular, spiral, scleriform, or reticulate. This already I have shown you. Same in the case of vessels also, we will see these thickenings, and vessels develop hardwood. So this is the hardwood, also called the porous wood. So porous wood is made by vessels, whereas the soft wood or non-porous wood is made by the tracheids. It also helps in the conduction of water. Already discussed that the vessels and the tracheids, their main function is to conduct the water, give mechanical support, and helps in the formation of wood. Then about xylem fiber. Right, xylem fiber. Okay, wherever you will see the fiber word, that their main function is to give the mechanical support, right? And they are dead sclerenchymatous cells found in the xylem. As I told you that xylem parenchyma is the only living cell. Rest of them are the dead cells. These are the long, narrow, with thick lignified wall and tapering ends. If you see them, xylem fibers are divided into two, fiber tracheids and libriform fiber. Fiber tracheids are similar to the tracheids with border pit. So pits are there which contains border around. And if libriform fiber are there, they are with the simple pit. Only pit is there, no border around. Okay, so they are divided into two, fiber tracheids and libriform fiber. Next is your parenchyma, xylem parenchyma. So parenchyma main function is to store. So they store starch and the fats. Okay, so they are the parenchymatous cells, thin walled, oval or elongated, present in both primary and the secondary xylem. In the both xylem they are present. Now about the function of xylem. So already we had discussed all the xylems. Xylem parenchyma, they helps to store the food. Okay, xylem fiber, they give the mechanical support. Parenchyma stores food. And tracheids and vessels, their main function is to conduct water, minerals, and they also helps in the formation of wood. Right, now let's move on to the phloem. So phloem is made up of four components. They are the sieve tubes, companion cell, phloem parenchyma and the phloem fiber. So out of these four components, only the phloem fiber is dead. In the xylem, we have seen only the xylem parenchyma is living, rest of them are dead. But in the phloem, you will see the phloem fiber is dead and rest of the three are the living. Right? Now, sieve tube. About sieve tube, they are elongated, cylindrical, tube-like living cells. They are non-nucleated at maturity. So, as they get mature, nucleus is not there. Between two sieve tubes, there are present perforated sieve plates with many sieve pores. I'll show you the plate here. So here you can see, this is the sieve tube. Here you will see the plates at the end. So these are the plates which contain many pores. These are known as the sieve plates. Okay. See this diagram highlighted is there. These are the sieve plates. Right. And this is the sieve tube. And near to the sieve tube, you will always find a companion cell which contains its own nucleus. Then there is phloem parenchyma and the phloem fiber. Right, so now this is very important. During the winter season, polysaccharide substance callose gets deposited on the sieve plates. So on the sieve plates, this callose gets deposited, due to which the food is not able to transfer. Okay, but as soon as the spring season comes, these callose substance are get dissolved and again the food can be transferred, and the transfer of food through the phloem is known as the translocation. Right, now about the companion cells, they are elongated, narrow, thin walled living cells associated with the sieve tubes. Okay, and they are placed side by side with them. Okay, they are always present side to the sieve tube. The sieve tube and the companion cells are connected through the pits. They are connected with each other through the pits. Here some pits are there. And they help in the transport of food along with the sieve tubes. Then about your phloem parenchyma. Phloem parenchyma are elongated, pointed, living, thin-walled parenchymatous cells. Again, I am telling you that parenchyma always stores food. Their main function is to store food. It also contains oil, starch and details. It is absent in monocots plant. See this diagram. This is in this you will see very clearly the xylem and the phloem. Okay, in between the xylem and the phloem, there is a cambium ring. So these are the sieve tubes and these are the sieve plates. Okay, these are the sieve tubes and these are the sieve plates, which contains many pores inside, and this is your xylem. Right, now next is your phloem fiber. Phloem fiber are the dead cells and they have lignified walls with pits. And fiber main function is to give the mechanical support to the plant. Always remember this, fiber always give mechanical support. Parenchyma, their main function is to store the food. Right, now beside these two, they are meristematic and the permanent, we have another specialized type of tissues known as the secretory tissues. So the cells of the protoplasts secrete certain products like enzymes, hormones, and these enzymes, hormones get stored as a waste excretory product, which have very great economic value to man. Example are resins, gums, rubber, oils, and some volatile oils also. So these are all the excretory products, and they are secreted by the secretory tissues. So on the basis of morphological and the physiological characters, the secretory tissues are classified as laticiferous tissues and the glandular tissues. So the laticiferous tissues contain latex, okay, and the cells which contains latex are known as the laticiferous tissues. And the latex is generally milky whitish in color, and sometimes it may be watery, for example in mucosa, or orange papaver, it is a colorful in papaver, and milky in the calotropis. Example are opium, papaver somniferum, rubber from the Huer brasilimis, papain, carica papaya, then chewing gum from sapota fruits, asafoetida from the ferula asafoetida. So these are all the materials which are obtained from these plants. Right? You have to learn these names. Asafoetida is obtained from ferula asafoetida. Rubber is very important. It is obtained from Huer brasilimis and the Ficus elastica. Papain from the carica papaya. Chewing gum from the sapota fruits, and opium from the papaver somniferum. So these are secreted by the laticiferous tissues. Then there are glandular tissues also. So some of the plants contain glands which secrete nectar, water also. So they are secreted by the glandular tissue. So these are the secretory tissues. So besides the permanent and the meristematic tissues, some specialized tissues are also there. They are known as the secretory tissues. And there are two types, laticiferous tissue and the glandular tissue.